Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and friends.
Good evening.
Everyone has their own comfort zone, where they're comfortable and confident. Some people's bubble is bigger than others. Unfortunately for me, I grew up in my own tiny bubble, safe and hidden. Hidden from all the harsh challenges and hardships of the outside world. As a child, I thought I was happy. I thought I was contented. Because what could be better than going to school, getting excellent grades, coming back home, doing my homework, and then doing it all over again? In primary school, all I did was study. And even if I do say so myself, I was excellent at it. Because that was the only thing I did. But then high school came around. And I started to realize that there was more to life than just my tiny bubble of comfort. There are so many more things that I did not know about, and I had not tried. Most importantly, there are so many more things that I'm not good at. And what shattered me the most was the fear. I knew I hated failing. I knew I was afraid of trying new things. Good at the sports. I was never an athletic child. I couldn't run as fast as the other kids. I couldn't score a goal for my life. And no one wanted me in their teams. I was dead weight at every team sport I was forced to play in during PE classes. I was that girl who couldn't run for her life. And if you knew me back then, PE class was the worst class ever. PE class was everyone's favorite, but it wasn't mine. And even if I didn't show it, I felt like a loser. But then, my comfort zone expanded a tiny bit when I found CrossFit. I gradually found what I could potentially be good at, despite the failures. I started believing in myself more, especially with people who believed in me more than I did. The one person who pushed me through everything was Nacho, a CrossFit coach, and one of the very few people who understands me fully. Then, that was the real challenge. Only a few months after I started CrossFit, I signed myself up for my very first competition, the Beast of the Southeast, a competition that required me to run, weightlift, and do gymnastics at a high intensity. What I did was sign myself up for something that I would never have done in a million years. If you think that that was the end of it, and I learned my lesson, that's where you're wrong. Signing up was one thing. Training for the competition was another. I had to face countless nights of practice, and I never felt enough. Some nights were bearable, but other nights were horrible. These were nights when I asked myself, why do I even bother? Why do I even care to put myself through hell when I know I have never been good at this? I was never made for this. I wasn't destined to do this. These were the nights when I couldn't tell which was worse, the pain of breathlessness, or the pain aching through my entire body, or the pain of failure. Training for each and every event got me panting and gasping for air, running for dear life, and just trying to survive each and every workout. My body was screaming for a break. My leg muscles were building lactic stomach acid and burning all over while I'm just trying to survive the workout. I could feel my pulse beating in my ears. I was battling both my mental and physical pain simultaneously. The thought of giving up in the midst of it all constantly popped into my mind. But of course, support is all that left me. Shouts and yells to come on, pick it up, let's go, slowly picked me up. And even if I crawled to the finish line, I got there. If I were to tell you right now how many nights I almost burst into tears just in training itself, you'd think I'm crazy. But all it took was a good rest, speak the pain away, and the day would start with more and more desire to compete and be better. Competition day finally arrived, and I was numb beyond explanation. I had to do all the things I could never even do in my worst nightmares. I had to run through the jungle alone. I had to lift weights I'd never even lifted above my head. And I had to get all the cardio exercise I never did for the last 19 years of my life. How on earth was I going to do that just 2 days of competition? No amount of practice and training could make me anywhere near ready for that. The numbness quickly turned into nervousness before each and every bet. I remember the weight looking back on the very first day. My heart was beating like a drum in my chest, and my body turned ice cold. My face was ghostly pale, while my head was pounding with a crazy painful headache. I started to warm up with an empty barbell. But when I attempted to make the lift, I failed. My heart started beating twice as fast, and I panicked. I felt my face go hot and my eyes start with water as I frantically scanned the crowd for my coach. It was only a few minutes away to the start of the event. I didn't have to say anything because my face said it all. But I was assured that I would do just fine, and we were all ushered to the platform. Stepping onto the platform and looking around me, I saw many familiar faces, and I knew I could not let family down. Most importantly, I couldn't let myself down. My vision went blurry, but I could hear the screams of support and encouragement. That was enough to help me hang on. I plucked my last few strands of courage up and surprised myself with one successful lift. Probably no one else noticed at that time, but my comfort zone started expanding from then on. The rest of the competition was a series of emotional roller coasters. Most of my low points consisted of me thinking to myself in the middle of an intense workout, what if I just give up right now? What if I just plop down on the floor right now in front of everyone? They can't possibly hold that against me, can they? The problem was, I knew deep down that I would hold that against myself. Through my high and low points during the two-day competition, Nashua was there. Pick me up when I fell and give me a pat on the back for every little victory I achieved. At the end of the last day of the competition, I couldn't have been happier. With the amazing memories I have made, but best of all, the priceless experience and lessons it offered. I found my new and I overcame them. It was the toughest battle I ever had to fight. It wouldn't have been worth it if it wasn't. Ladies and gentlemen, you can either be comfortable or courageous. but you cannot be both. You can either hide under your safety blanket or see what the world has to offer. It's up to you to fight through your blood, sweat, and tears to break your limits. If you want something you've never had, you have to do something you've never done. We are all only one step away from discovering amazing things about ourselves. Pluck that courage up.